Hello, plastic model builders. We're going to finish up the ordinance for this model, or at least half of it, so you can see what we're doing here. I got to paint some more of this stuff here and finish up some of these. I added this tail piece because I guess I forgot to do that when I built these. So I got to find out where I was before I was left off and I kept getting canceled out by my own internet. And let's see what we have to do. This is all painted here. Got the tail painted. All these wonderful colors. So these are ready to decal. I do have to finish up. Let's see. Have to paint the tips on these X6, whatever that is. I don't know. I'm sure I've got it marked here somewhere, the small little deal that it is. Orange. Have to get out orange. Good thing I've got orange because I bought a whole bottle of paint for $5 or whatever paint costs now. So I could paint the tips orange. Yes, just the tip. Just the tip. We all know what that is. Lots of missiles. Always playing just the tip because you just have to paint the tip of it. Remember when you were a kid and you watched The Simpsons? You thought it was really funny. And your parents didn't like it because they thought there was a lot of stuff in there you shouldn't be watching. But that's because they were adults. And they forgot that you didn't understand 90% of the stuff that they were saying. But you did. I'm sorry. You didn't understand it. But they did. And that was the problem. But then, as you got older, and you still watch The Simpsons, because you know, the show is still on 30 years later, longest running cartoon in the history of the planet, I think. All of a sudden, now you're noticing stuff that is really interesting when you watch the show. Such as all the jokes that they made that, most kids might not understand. Anywho, we're going to paint these tips here. Or at least try. That's one tip down. Look how pretty that looks. Model making madness. Make stuff look pretty. It's a lot of tips. Four tips. And a partridge and a pear tree. By the way, painting tips and being blind as a bat and taking off your glasses at the same time doesn't work very well, especially when you're trying to record stuff because you gotta let you guys see it in the camera and all sorts of fun stuff. There we go. That looks really nice. I like that. I sure got my money's worth out of that paint. Maybe one day I'll put that orange to good use. All right, so slowly working out all the painting that needs to be done. And then I'm going to show you these missiles as well, how they sit inside of this, which is really interesting because I've already done a test of it. So there are some things that don't actually need painting, but we will get it taken care of. Okay, so I need to mix up some paint here. Some chrome silver. And some black. So this paint job here is going to be for the fins right here of the Sidewinder missile. Let's see what the Sparrows are painted, if they need that same color, and they do. The fins of the Sparrows. It is a 1-to-1 ratio. Actually, you know what? Hopefully that's enough. We're going to hand paint these. This color looks almost like a gunmetal or a chrome type. There we go. Here's to hoping we don't mess this up in any way, shape, or form. That doesn't look too bad. We'll see what that looks like when it dries. that is one color down. We don't have to see anymore. Couple more left to go. Clean out this dastardly paint. I hate working with metallics, as you know. Okay. One thing we do need to paint, though. Are these right here? They go straight X11. Not much of these will be seen, so it's not too big a deal. I'm probably just wasting my time doing this, but we're going to paint these since the directions say to, in case, depending on how you want to do your model. And the only bit you're really going to see out of these is that right there. But we're just kind of going to give a little bit of those on the inside. There you go. There are six of these. The rest I have on the sprue. And they will probably stay there. Just going to paint the rest of them right here. Remember, you're not going to see any of this actually, and I will show you why here in a minute. Because these have a special place in the plane, which make it look like a work of art. By the way, thank you for watching, and of course, don't forget to subscribe, comment, and like. All right, I promised you some fun stuff, and I am going to show it to you. You're going to take this right here. Each one of these has a spot. That is the square one. It's going to be heck to get these out. That goes like that. This one goes right here. We will take this. See, they only go one way. Big hole and long hole. So we get to do two holes at once. Push that in just like that. All right. Now, as you can see, this is how this is going to look. Boom. Just like that. That's about as much as it that you're going to see, which is not a lot, but that's how that's going to go, which also means that you don't really have to worry about painting that top side to these unless you feel like having it complete. I did, of course, as you can see, but that's how that's going to go, just like that. And that's why you got to make your plane look pretty. We're going to weather this eventually. So, and I still haven't put in the side pieces. Still waiting on that. But as for this, so this can wait a little bit more. I'm going to slowly take that out. Here's to hoping I can get these out. There's one. Actually, these can probably stay in there. There's no need for me to not leave these in. And since they're already in there, I may as well go ahead and glue them in since they're there. This one, push it down all the way. There we go. Just like that. What you think? You like that? Can I get two snaps up with the twist? All right, back to painting. Since the video is about painting and decaling, X2. Going to need some X2 and XF2. Of course, each one of these models also has a lot of, let's see here, hold on. X11. All right, we're still using X11, so I capped it up. I don't know why, but I'm going to spin it again. Well, that looks fine and dandy, doesn't it? I've seen images of people weathering the Ordinance, but what I hear, Ordinance is not really weathered because it's pretty much is what it is. That looks wonderful. And these might be seen. I don't know. We got a little mystery on that one. That'll be all right. Oh my. I have one more sidewinder to paint, but I don't know where I put it. I have to find that real quick. There we go. These are looking good so far. And I think all I need are the white colors, and I think we'll be done. Got to blow on that sometimes with the tip. Let it dry faster. All right. And then paint the sparrows. I'm getting nothing out of that one. That one's dry. Try paint number two. No, the camera isn't shaking. That's just me. I'm sure plenty of y'all can relate to that. That looks really nice. Let's sit a second before we give it a second coat. And let's see if I'm done all my painting here. Lots of colors on here. X2, X10 did that combination. Did the AS-26, that missile's done. Over on the bottom here, X6 did that, X-26 did the olive drab color. I don't see anything else there. And we got these. Did the X-11 silver, did the AS-26 on the tip there. Did the olive drab, all of that, and AS-26. And then the sidewinders, AS-26, did the white, did the X-11 there, and then on the fins. So those are done. We can decal. Finally. Oh my. See if this is dried yet. I just hit this and scraped a bit of paint off on it. That's okay. I like it. Not perfect, but it will work. So this decal process is going to be a little bit tedious because there's a lot of them. As I mentioned earlier, and I guess a bunch of y'all want to watch me do them all and kill things. Because, I mean, they are small decals and we all know nobody likes putting on 20 decals on a bunch of missiles. But it is what it is and it be what it be. Model making madness, make them look pretty. I'll just show you each one of them. So we are going to start with the JBU-31s, JDAMs, whatever the heck that stands for. Somebody will tell me eventually. All right, so the number 326 on each one of these. I got a pair of scissors somewhere. It also makes me wonder how many people are about as disorganized as me when it comes to building their models. Scissors are where all good people keep scissors, in the bathroom. Because, I mean, why would we keep them anywhere else, right? While that sits, we will cut out some more of these pretty little decals. Need number 328, 329, and 327. If you choose to put a pilotless cockpit in, there are the decals for that. Okay. probably could have painted these yellow, but I did not. There we go. Gonna let that dry. Get the next ones. Which will be 328 and 329. And 327, of course. guided bomb unit. Finally, words pop up. Joint direct attack ammunition. I'm reading. Well, at least I'm not the only one that's disorganized. Thanks for watching, by the way. Well, there's one down. Looks good. Do another one. By the way, each one kind of comes with each thing. That's the first one. Next one we are going to do is the Sparrows. Brain just went out the door. How many decals does this one have? Only 11. 11 decals for a missile. I'm excited, and of course, there they are, all labeled. M120, C, AMRAAM, Big Ben, Parliament, Camp. I don't know if the inside is supposed to represent, I guess it's red inside, isn't it? I don't know. Does that mean it's getting fired or just how they want it to look? Whatever. I'll put the decals on. One thing I've learned over my years of modeling and doing missiles is to do this. Cut off that little clear bit because that just can make every missile a pain to do. Slow and easy, we'll win this race. I hope. The hardest part about doing these is touching them. As you can see, I tend to do that. There we go. This is like the worst thing ever. Magic trick I found to putting on the round ones is just to put a little bit of a liquid in the first part of the application. And in theory, it will get sucked right up. The decal will just wrap its way all the way around. Oh, and by the way, I cut off the little ends on that. Got ahead of the game. Oh boy. Got my directions wet. I stuck them in water. So that's a wonderful thing. Yeah, it is tedious, but I mean, the models do look good. I think on the F-4B, I put on a lot of the decals, but I think on the previous models after that, I was like, I'm not putting all these little decals on. I'm just not going to do it. Somebody said they kind of wear off anyway after a while, so I was just like, no. Let's see here, 337. 333 is on. 334. Okay. So a lot of these, what I've done, I'm trying to group them in a... Oopsies. Why is it all the numbers still kind of stay on there? That way I know what's what. So that is the Sparrow. So this is fun. It's got 16 decals. See here, one, two, that's paint. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Oh, that's not bad. Eight for the sidewinder. We're slowly narrowing this down, getting them done. And only like five more missiles to go. I don't know. Good thing we're only doing a couple of them, huh? Okay, so let's see what we need here. So for the Sparrow, that's what I kind of cut off for this decal. I'm assuming that's going to go on properly. It does look like part of that corner right there will have to just come off just a little bit. And that's exactly how I cut it as well. Too small. Okay. There is that little corner right there. And I was talking about, because this butts right up to the edge.
Oopsies.
This is a fun marathon. I thank you all for watching with me, by the way. Well, we're almost done with the sidewinder. Have to put on two more decals in Australian terms or English terms, British, whatever you want to call it. So the first one goes on like this, and it's upside down. And the other one going like this. Same thing with the instruction. It will appear upside down. So, make sure you get it right.
wouldn't be prudent at this juncture.
Okay, sidewinder one is done. This is it. You know what I did forget though? I forgot something. On that. I'm sure you can figure out what it is. It's the flame. But I really don't think it's a flame. I think it actually is in the missile. It's the back of it usually has that little red thing in there, and then it just gets catapulted out. But here's the sidewinder. I hope I've done it justice. This here looks a little bit crooked. Okay. All right, 16 wonderful decals left and 32 parts, Mr. Mellon. And here they all are, in all their glory. Not to remember, there's also four of these wonderful paveway twos. Sometimes when you're overwhelmed, the best thing to do is you just start somewhere and get it done, which is what we're going to do. Okay, so the first one is from the top, which is just like this. Number 344. You know, maybe it won't be so bad once you get started. There are 16 of them. Go one by one, they will get done. And before you know it, you're finished, which is my goal. This one's got a little dot right there, and this dot's going to line up with this, hopefully. We'll see how this works out because it's rounded. Maybe I should have done a little cutting ahead of time, but you got to live and learn. I'll just kind of let that rest there. Gonna soak up, I imagine. We got 339. Goes right there. And 343. And a little trick, I don't know if people know about this. You are smart though. Put your paintbrush there and it will soak up some of that water. Like I said, we're gonna let that one sit. We'll hit it with some micro set, some micro sol. Okay. Top. So that's the top. The left. I assume that means turn it this way. This says decal number 342. We are going to do some cutting real quick. It's half of that one. Hopefully that worked. Good thing I didn't get cut by my rolling knife. So on this one, I know it's hard to see the instructions. I think the big letters, or at least the longer lines, go on the bottom there. Almost done the left side. Spilled my micro set. Go figure. Trying to cap it up so I don't spill it. I always spill 90% of those bottles every time. I'm sure everybody else knows exactly what I'm talking about too. Okay. I need to turn this way. Okay, boys and girls, I've got all the decals on. One last thing left to do. And that is to go through and put all the microsol on them. Wherever the heck I put that. Here we go. This is the absolute last bit of stuff we've got to do. Making sure I haven't missed any decals on here. Is the A9. For the sidewinder. There they are. All these missiles in all their glory. Those are them. 2 hours and 42 minutes of decaling and fun stuff. So, thanks for watching. Subscribe, comment, and like. And I'll see you tomorrow doing some stuff. Bye.